Hi everyone, it's Bianca here. Welcome to a new tutorial. In this tutorial we make this super easy flower square. Let's get started. For this square we need two different colors of yarn, crochet hook, a needle and a scissor. With the first color we make a slip knot on the hook. And then we make a chain 6. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And then we close here with a slip stitch in the first chain stitch. Round 1, we have here a little circle, and in this circle we make all the way around double crochets with between a chain 3. Your first double crochet is a chain 3. It's 1, 2, 3. Now we have to make a chain 3, make a chain 3 more. It's 1, 2, 3. We have here a chain 6, the first chain 3 is a double crochet, and then we made a chain 3. Now here in that circle make one double crochet, yarn over, enter your hook in that little circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. And then make a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. This double crochet and that chain 3 we make all the way around, so we have 8 double crochets in total. Yarn over, enter your hook in that same circle. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, and then make a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. We have your 3 double crochets. Make one more double crochet in that circle. Then make a chain 3. Double crochet in that circle. Chain 3. Double crochet in that circle. Chain 3, double crochet in the circle, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Make a chain 3, one more double crochet to go in that same circle, then we have to make a chain 3. Now we all the way around, we have 8 double crochets in total with between a chain 3. Now we make a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet, and that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. It's 1, 2, 3 in that stitch, go in with your hook, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. Cut the yarn and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. Round 2, slip knot on the hook with the second color, and we begin with a standing double crochet in a chain 3 space. It doesn't matter which one, you choose one. The yarn is on the hook. Yarn over, enter your hook in a chain 3 space, then grab your yarn, pull up. You have now 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, and pull for 2. This is a standing double crochet. Now in that same space make 3 more double crochets. Yarn over, enter your hook in that same space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. 2 more double crochets in that same space. So we have here 4 double crochets in that same chain 3 space. Now make a chain 2. 1 and 2. And this is the repeat you work all the way around. I'll show you once more. We skip the next double crochet, and then in the next chain 3 space make 4 double crochets in that same space. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 double crochets, and then make a chain 2. Repeat all the way around till you have 8 groups of 4 double crochets with between and chain 2. I'm all the way around, 8 groups of 4 double crochets in that same space with between and chain 2. After that last group of 4 double crochets, don't forget to make that chain 2 here on the end. Now we cut the yarn because we make an invisible join in the beginning. Now open up that stitch, pull the hook all the way up like this. Then I grab the needle for an invisible join. We skip always that first stitch, that's the standing double crochet. You go to the next stitch, and then on the top of that stitch, under through that V, from the front to the back, then pull through. And then you go to the last stitch, and that's the chain 2, the second chain stitch, only here in the back loop. Go in with your needle. Then pull through, and this stitch here, this little V stitch here, is your invisible join. Now weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. Round 3, the first color is back on the hook with a slip stitch. And we begin in a chain 2 space with a standing double crochet. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in a chain 2 space. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. Now here in that same chain 2 space, make 5 more double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. With your first standing double crochet, you have now 6 double crochets all in that same chain 2 space. Make a chain 2, 1 and 2, and this is the repeat. You work all the way around in each chain 2 space, make 6 double crochets, and then between and chain 2. So we skip over the next 4 double crochets, and then in the next chain 2 space make 6 double crochets. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and then make and chain 2. Work like this all the way around, and then we make again an invisible join in the second stitch. I worked all my stitches all the way around. After that last group of 6 double crochets, make also a chain 2, and then cut the yarn. Open up that stitch. Then with the needle we make an invisible join in the beginning. And we skip always that first stitch. That's the standing double crochet. You go to the next stitch, under through that V. Back to the last stitch. That's the chain 2, the second chain, only in the back loop. Weave both tails in. Round 4, with the second color back on the hook, and we begin with a standing single crochet in a chain 2 space. The yarn is on the hook, enter your hook in that chain 2 space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and put for 2 for a standing single crochet. Make a chain 3, 1, 2 and 3. Now we skip the next 3 double crochets, 1, 2, 3. And then between the 2 times 3 double crochets, not on the top of the 4th stitch, but between the 2 double crochets, make 1 single crochet. So between those stitches, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and put for 2. Make a chain 3. Skip the next 3 double crochets and then here in the next chain 2 space make 1 single crochet. Make a chain 3. Skip the next 3 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, and then between the next 2 double crochets, not on the top of the 4th double crochet, but between the stitches, make 2 double crochets. Yarn over, enter your hook between those stitches, make 1 double crochet, yarn over, back in that same space with a second double crochet. Make a chain 3. Now go back into that same space with another 2 double crochets. It's 1 and 2. Make a chain 3. Skip the next 3 double crochets and then in the next chain 2 space make 1 single crochet. Repeat all these stitches all the way around. Make a chain 3, skip 3 double crochets and then between the next 2 double crochets, here between those stitches, make 1 single crochet. Chain 3, skip the next 3 double crochets, then in the next chain 2 space, 1 single crochet. Chain 3. Now we make again a corner between the 3rd and the 4th double crochet. Between those stitches, make 2 double crochets. Chain 3. 2 double crochets back into that same space. Make a chain 3, skip 3 double crochets into the next chain 2 space, make 1 single crochet. This is the way how you work all the way around. I made all my stitches all the way around. After that last corner, you work also in chain 3. It's 1, 2 and 3. Cut the yarn. Open that stitch. We make our last invisible join. We skip the first stitch, that's the standing single crochet. You go to the next stitch, that's the first chain stitch of that 3. You go under through that V stitch, not here in that space, but under through that V of that chain, pull through. Back to the last stitch, that's the chain 3 in the 3rd chain stitch only in the back loop, then pull through, on the back we make a little knot like this, and one more. So now you can weave the tails in on the back of the stitches, and then the square is complete. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!